ends, probably Tango. Nah, in La Puta with the Draco.
Yeah.
Hey, look, I see your baby daddy here, Buster. He wanna be like me, but he ain't got no hustle. Baby, I'm the type of nigga, get it off the muscle. And I like to tow them stones, ain't got time to tussle. She wanna eat my chip, but she can't get these ruffles. I got it out the mud, got my knuckles. You the type to get on one knee and tell her you love her, but I'm the type to take a nigga. We do it undercover, cruising down the street in my Stolo, jacking these.
Stay out here to work. If you ain't ready to work, stay home.
Let's go.
Stay home. Don't come.
All right, so we got the first day of OTAs on Orlando Americans. Jeez.
What's up? What's up? What's up?
Man, tell the great people that are watching how you feel about today. Let's introduce your coaches. And give me your opinion of going into this new league.
Man, well, first of all, I never get too excited about first days, first weeks, first part of the season because just like all teams out there, everybody loaded at the first part of their year. The OTAs, everybody loaded. Everybody excited, everybody hyped, everybody get out there and they want to play. But when they get out there, like you see the people we got out there, and they're not getting the playing time they want, and things not going their way, they start fading away. So that's why I never get excited about the first days of OTAs. But I'm always appreciative of the guys that come out, that's working hard, and I just, you know, I hope they stick through the overhaul, through the long road.
Okay. So introduce your coaches that you have on your staff today.
Well, I got my return offensive coordinator, assistant head coach. Coach Garnier Rackley, they call him G-Rack. Many of you guys know him already. He's instrumental in running our offense as well as instrumental in moving players on to the next level. He sent three players to the Orlando Predators this year. A couple other players playing overseas or somewhere, they're getting paid. But that's pretty much what he does for this organization. He's a good coach. He's well-connected. And so, and he's a good friend. Then I got Coach Panky down there working with the D-line. He's been with me since 2003, since I first started the program. He's been with me. He's a defensive line coach. He also coaches at Wekiva High School. But he's been around for a long time, dinosaur in this business, and a very good coach. Then I got Coach Doug Sasser. He's down there. He's working with our linebackers. Last year, he was on the staff. That's the first time we worked together. He was our wide receivers coach. But he came over to the defensive side this year. He's going to work with the linebackers. That's Coach Doug Sasser. And then I got a new coach. Y'all know him as Coach Unc West. He came over from the Tar Heels. He's going to be doing my defensive backs and my special teams. Very knowledgeable. He's a good recruiter. I'm hearing. I haven't yet seen that. And he's a good condition coach too as well. So that's pretty much the coaches I have right now. We're still in search of a running backs coach and a receivers coach. Called Coach G-Rack going to be coaching the quarterbacks. So that's my staff as we have it right now.
All right. We left the FFA last year. We went into first round of playoffs, I want to say, and lost, sadly. Leaving the FFA, going into the new lead, please introduce the new lead and how do you feel going into this new lead?
New league we're going to is the EAFL, the Elite Amateur Football League. Elite, I don't know, Elite, is Elite, what it is, Elite what? Anyway, it's Torres League. Typically leagues are about the same. It comes down to the teams and the ownerships, if they want to follow the rules of the league and the vision of the league. But one thing that this league is setting up to have that no other league have is pretty much bringing all the teams together in the state of Florida as well as some teams in Georgia. So it's gonna be interesting and exciting. We're looking forward to take part of this league and looking forward to turn some heads. A lot of people don't believe in us. A lot of people think we're trash. But we're gonna surprise some people this year. We got we got a good nucleus of players coming back, and then we got a good group of guys, talented guys coming in.
All right. So tell the people, what's new for the Americans this year? What are you looking for, and what do you have planned for the Americans?
On the field?
On and off the field. What you got for Orlando?
On the field, more excitement, more up-tempo style of play, and more violence. We want to bring more violence to the field on the defensive side of the ball, as well in the trenches for the offensive side, and then have an up-tempo brand of play. I think we done got the first year jitters out the way. A lot of the guys who were the first time playing in the FFA, playing on a level, a competition like that, and so I think they done got that behind them, and so we're looking to turn up on the field. Off the field, we want to continue to do the things that we try to do in the community. Get a bigger community presence. We got some things in store as far as coming on YouTube, developing our own YouTube channel, and doing something like a Hard Knock segment on a weekly basis, and some other things we're working on. You know, we already know that we got a partnership with a bus company, so we get our bus for our transportation, for our on-the-road games. We have some of the better uniforms in the league. We adding a fourth set this year, a special set. And so we just always trying to push the bar. Always trying to push the bar. Never settling on what we did last year. Just trying to continue to get better.
All right, man. I appreciate this time. Let's get back to these OTA. Yes, sir, man. You got some coaches.
I got one more thing left to say.
All right, tell them.
Look out for the Americans.